Who about the sun takes number one.
Who was most chaste shall be first place.
The most inglorious is victorious.
The winning contestant was the most protestant. But tonight we're going to answer your questions once and for all.
To know.
That's right. We're here to help you figure out which one of us is
the Queen of the Castle,
the Rose among the Thorns,
the Thomas Cromwell amongst the Royal Ministers between 1532 and 1535.
So I'm like, no way. You must agree, the baby in all the time I've been by your side. I've never lost control, no matter how many times I knew you lied. And my golden rule. And even though you had your fun hanging around with some pretty young thing, and even though you had one son with someone who don't own a wedding ring, no matter what I heard, I didn't say a word. There you be. I put up with your shh like every single day.
Yeah.
time.
I think you're thinking of me.
No, that was definitely a really important one.
Yeah, still me.
No, I think she like overlapped with you.
No, yeah, the really famous and controversial one that people actually care about.
Yeah,
the one you've been waiting for.
Really like my head.
I know his times with the Queens before me had been hard, but they were also full of fire. He raged and stormed at them, and because they were both absolute badass monarchs, they raged and stormed right back. But I didn't do any of that. Instead, I stood by him like I was made of stone. I stood firm no matter his flaws, his tempers. No matter my doubts or fears, I stayed there, by his side. And that's not because I was scared or naive or weak. It's because I loved him.
Stay.
perfect family. You hold us close for the world to see. And when I say you're the only one I've ever loved, I mean those words truthfully. But I know without my son, your love could disappear. I know it isn't fair, but I don't care, 'cause my love will still be here. You can blow me up, you can tear me down, you can try, but I'm unbreakable. You can do your best, but I'll stand the test. You'll find that I'm unshakable. When the fire's burned, the wind has blown, the water's dried, you'll still find stone.
My heart of stone.
Welcome to the house of Holy Mike. Germany.
The king chooses bad, but which one will it be?
Who brings the corsets?
Who brings the cinches?
No one wants a face over 9 inches.
No one to see my cup contain lead poison.
At least your complexion will bring us a poison.
She'll still walk at 40.
Looking for mates, dates, and a British moniker for him to secure the line of succession. Vicky face.
9? Well, never mind. She already has a match with the Duke of Milan anyhow.
Okay, next, Your Highness. May we present Emilia of Cleves. Just a German girl trying to live the English dream. Hashtag no Catholics. Hashtag big dowry.
Okay, who's next?
Fantastisch.
Wunderbar. Your Highness, Your Highness, Your Highness, we are honored to present to you Anna of Cleves,
the most beautiful woman in the whole of the Holy Roman Empire.
And let me assure you, her Holbein has certainly done her justice.
Be happily married for many years to come.
Ah, I can see it now. Henry VIII and his famous 4 wives.
Oh, no need to thank us. The pleasure has been ours.
In the house of Holbein!
The house of Holbein. The way they are, didn't live up to his expectations. I mean, it's the usual story, isn't it? The savvy, educated young princess, deemed repulsive by a wheezing, wrinkled, ulcerated man, 24 years her senior.
Rejection. Rejection from a king. How can anyone overcome a fate as devastating as being forced to move into a resplendent palace in Richmond?
Sitting here all alone on a throne in a palace that I happen to own. Bring me some pheasant, keep it on the bone. Fill my goblet up to the brim, sipping on me, then I spill it on my dress with a gold lace trim. Not very prim and proper. Make me stop. I wanna go hunting. Any takers? I'm not fakers. I've got acres and acres. Paid for with my own riches.
stitches. When my hands out, release the bitches.
Woof.
Every day. I'm like a croquet, cause I'm a player. And tomorrow, I'll hit replay.
You.
Okay,
right?
Same.
Oh, yeah, same. Nice neck, by the way.
Okay,
all right. How about this?
When my one and only child had a raging fever, Henry didn't let me, her mother, see her.
Oh,
I'm all you need, all you want, don't need to plead.
So yeah, that's a workout. Turns out some guys just employ women to get them into their private chambers.
Oh, different time back then.
So I decided to have a break from boys, you know, just focus on my career. And my dad got me this amazing work placement in court. And you'll never guess who I met? Tall, large, Henry VIII.
Supreme.
Head of the Church of England? Nobody revered.
Although you wouldn't know it, look at that beard.
Made me a lady in waiting, hurled me and my family up in the world, gave me duties in court, and he swears it's true that without me he doesn't know what he'd do.
One.
not two, but three historically confirmed mistresses.
Yeah, get over it. When I was queen, I had not one.
Not two. But three.
Miscarriages.
Oh, gosh.
Okay. Well, you know what, Anne Belusa? I had five miscarriages.
And I want to say
let's move on, shall we? Come on, queens. Katherine, it's your turn, babe. Take it away.
You know what? I'm good. Yeah, I can't keep doing this. I'm sorry. What? Sorry. Sorry. Oh, it's just that we're here with all of these people, like, let's see what gets the biggest cheer, trauma or abuse. Ooh, should we really be doing this?
I mean, we've literally been doing that for the last hour, so.
No, but miscarriages, isn't that a bit too much?
Someone's got a conscience all of a sudden.
I'm Katherine Parr, I draw the line in arbitrary places.
Queen, she just knows she's not going to win.
Yeah, so she's trying to make us look stupid instead of playing by the rules like everyone else.
You
know,
you have to
do that. Absolutely not.
Okay. You know what, Queens? If it's a sob story you want, I'll give you one.
Oh, are you sure, Katherine? Are you sure you don't want to stick to the backing vocals? You know where you belong.
No? You're right, I should sing a song, it's only fair. Take a sequence. Okay, ladies, how about tonight we try something a little different? Joan, could you give me a cheeky B flat major seventh? Perfect. Okay, just for a bit of context, I've actually had my fair share of marriages. Something Henry and I have in common, I guess. Though, unlike him, I did manage to get through mine without decapitating anyone. I know, gold star for Kathy Parr. But they did have this really annoying habit of passing away, so as well as dealing with, you know, incapacitating grief, I also had to keep finding new husbands to avoid being ostracized. Yep, Tudor womanhood, would recommend. But then finally, one day, this guy, Thomas. He seemed like he might stick around for a while, and you guessed it, he turned out to be the love of my life. I know, right? We had this plan to get married, actually, but that's when Henry showed up, single and ready to make an unsuspecting woman his wife. Just my luck. So that was that. I had to write a letter to Thomas, ending things. Dear Tom, you know I love you, boy, in every single way, though I love you, boy, I'll miss you every day. Oh, I love you, boy, and I wish that I could stay with you and keep the life I made with you. And even though this feels so right, I'm holding back the tears.
great, I don't get it.
Look, why do any of these people know who we are?
My sixth finger.
Put it away, babe.
Okay, let me put it a different way. Who was Henry the Seventh's wife?
I don't know.
Anyone?
And
who was Henry the Sixth's wife?
I don't know.
And Henry the Fifth's wife?
We don't know.
Look, the point is, the only reason any of these people came here tonight is because, once upon a time,
the same guy fell in love with us.
Right. But isn't there a bigger problem here?
The dissolution of the monasteries.
No. I'm talking about us. Because when we get together as a group,
everyone notices Jane can't dance.
What? Wives of Henry VIII, we each become just that.
One of his wives.
One of...
six.
OMG, I get it. Since the only thing we have in common is our husband, grouping us is an inherently comparative act and as such necessarily elevates a historical approach ingrained in patriarchal structures. I read. We're stuck.
Wow, what a waste of time.
Well, I guess there's not much we can do about it now.
Do you know what would be really cool, though?
What?
If, like, you know, before we spent the whole show fighting, we realised that comparing ourselves would turn out to be such an interesting thing.
Yeah, that would
have been good. Yeah, because if we had realised, we could have thought of some really cool way to, like, reclaim our stories for ourselves. You know, like, remove Henry's love from our lives once and for all.
Oh, we could have done it as a song!
Do you know what?
Do you know what? That would have really tied things together so neatly. If only we'd thought of that before.
This is the real.
Because of, I don't know, his...
Six lives!
Yes, we can reclaim our stories, but we can't rewrite them.
And though we wish we could tell you our lives had happy endings,
in reality, they didn't.
And there's nothing we can do to change that.
Ever.
This is our show and we can literally have whatever ending we want.
So, London, seeing as there's 5 minutes left of the show,
we've decided to give you our own
slightly edited version of what actually went down all those years ago.
Because after all, we're one of a kind.
No category.